who's here? Is it Bob and Matt? Hey Bob, good note. I've got it a little louder this time, so hopefully that'll balance out well. So Bob, we're just doing a warm-up again. We'll go over to the start in a second. Alright, sorry the sound effects were so loud. That was weird. So this is gonna suck. This is not gonna be like groups of people attacking each other. This is the same start for us yesterday. So we're gonna exit like we're going to the jungle loop again. But then at the very start of the jungle loop circuit, we turn right and just climb up a virtual Alpe. So it's gonna immediately blow up. And then it's just gonna be everybody suffering alone for like an hour. And the climb will be even slower because we're all on mountain bikes. Should be interesting. And to clarify, it won't be interesting at all to watch. Be interesting for me, not so much for you. Hot purple, hot pink is not working for me. There you go. So I think there's really no sense for me in trying to stay with the front group. I'm just gonna soft pedal to the Alpe and then try to do a good steady effort on the Alpe. Looks like a lot of people have the same idea. It's like two guys who are gung-ho. So same time slot as previous stages, but this is just like a mentally very taxing course to ride. Most people don't enjoy the hour-long climb. Notice that it cut the field in half, the number of people who showed up to ride it. Half of what it was yesterday at the same time. So Bob, we talked about watts per kilogram yesterday. The climb is steep enough the whole time that watts per kg is all that's gonna matter. So like if I'm dangling, you know, 20 seconds behind someone, and they're doing the same watts per kilogram, and I'm at threshold, I'm gonna stay at 20 seconds behind them. It's really hard to close gaps unless you have more in the tank. I'll try to start it a little conservative and just try to stay consistent. Welcome aboard, Matt. I did get to glance at the signups as of like lunchtime today. Just based on the 20-minute numbers that people have recorded in recent events on Zwift, there aren't that many people who are really in the like mid threes and higher in watts per kilogram. So I think some people here are not exactly soft pedaling, and there should be a resettling of the relative positions on the climb. Matt, I don't know if I mentioned this to you. I might have. We're going on the Alpe d'Huez replica. So you get to see the 21 switchbacks. Probably should have held on to that group up there. Oh well. Trouble with the simulation getting too real, right, Bob? I wish the graphics were worse, so it wouldn't trick me. Keeping the power low, keeping the heart rate low. Trouble coming. Flat asphalt, coming up to a hard left turn and a wall. The kind of climb that makes riders comment to the group, good luck. Get overexcited here. Bob, what do you think your all-day heart rate is? What could you hold all day? By the way, the RPMs are totally wrong. I think there's a connection issue. Looks like it's half of what's real. Yeah, 120s, I'm sure you're right about that. Looks like one guy is way off the front. Yeah, Bob, I think the legs point you're making, that's gotta be true for just about everybody. It takes a pretty good buildup of muscular endurance to really get to the limits of what your cardio can handle. So it'll be interesting to watch this. Currently in 18th place. I wonder how many people are misjudging their climb. How many people are being conservative in the back. Could be a lot of reshuffling. I wish the cadence was right. This is just hard to look at. You got a little fatigue in the legs from the last 2 days. My heart rate is kind of decoupled from how I feel. I'm sure it hits that in several places, Bob. I think it averages like 9%. Maybe above 10, I'm not sure actually. It's hard. You can see the group stringing out. Yeah, Matt, it's a pretty good simulation. Get the whole experience. Could use the EPO though. So again, RPMs are way off, just double what you see. Already at over 170. Reco. D swag guys all over the map. He's doing intervals or something. Do you think his real name is Swag? Is my name Habit?
Should we all be in?
What?
Should we all be in? Swag.
Oh. Okay. It's a family broadcast. Swag's dropped it low again. Yeah, Bob, I don't like it either. RPM signal just corrected for a second, then crap back out. Thank you. Bob, any guesses why I thought about not streaming this? Fair enough, Bob. How you spend your time is your business. Mr. Duckworth, what's the deal? What, Matt? I don't understand. I hear there's no coronavirus at the top. Thank you. hands work again. Stretching out of the saddle here. Can you turn that pin up? No, I'll be okay. Duckworth making a move. Clark following. Ooh. Need some recovery. They look like they're on a tandem. Looks like this guy had a dropout down there. Whoa! Big guy moving fast. Impressive. Back with Duckworth. And back to recovery mode. Bit of a wall here. Duckworth returns. Such a long way to go still. Thank you. kind of pulling the ripcord here. Try not to, but it's happening. Arnak about to make the pass. Uh-oh. That's not good. You got it. Cool. I'm just saying I was putting on the brakes, Bob. Turned out the data connection did that for me. I was thinking that Arnak guy kind of came out of nowhere. Looks like he's done 5 miles less. Maybe he did a late join. Keeping the power low. I'm a little overheated right now, so just trying to get comfortable again. Looks like we're on our way up to Dutch Corner. See the orange up there? And the tour on the real Alpe is called Dutch Corner because all the fans from Holland get their early set up camp, put all their orange out, and yell for the Dutch riders. There were a couple of Dutch guys from the Low Country in the 80s who were just incredible climbers, so it became a tradition. Yeah, Matt, weather's changing. So is power output. Thank you. Yeah, Matt, I did. No power. Yeah, Bob, they're right now, but that wasn't to do with the drop. RPMs come from a different piece of machinery. Doing really low power and heart rate just won't come down. Overheated. Swag is back. Ooh. These guys kept something in the tank. So close, guys. can see the finish line on the map. One more turn, it just takes so long to get there. Here comes a pass I can do nothing about. Another big guy. Good work. Thank you. that I think it's just under 110, but I've never actually gone for it. Not that it would change that much. Probably be just under an hour. Another dropout. Cool. Why not? Guess I should be grateful for the rest. Oh man. Yeah, 273 for 121, 122. That's an overheated result. And there's the feather power up. Well, I think the takeaway is we suffer now so that next time is better. This was coming. Might as well get it out of the way sooner than later. Check out the Martian landscape. I guess. I'm gonna ride back down the hill, think about what I've done. Thanks for keeping me company. See you at the next one.